I think broadly speaking, we can divide the causation of cancer into two big categories. One part of the risk for cancer is actually got to do with the environment. What you didn't do, or what you do in excess, or what you've been consuming and what the environment has been doing to you, external influences. Of course, the other big piece of the risk is actually your genes, something that you have no choice, you're born with that. So if you combine the two together, the summation of the effects of this environment and gene interaction will determine your real risk of cancer, which is why we often see some people who are probably taking a lot of risk with their lives, smoking, bad lifestyle, bad habits, but they get on well with life and they don't necessarily fall sick and get a cancer. Whereas on the other hand, there are people who are extremely careful with what they eat, what they do, and yet at an early age, they are stricken with cancer. And that shows out the interplay of genes and an environment. So you could have very good genes, you can abuse yourself with a bad environment, and you might be lucky. But if you've got bad genes, no matter how careful you are with what you eat, what you do, you might get cancer before you're 30 or you're 40. So in broad terms, genes and environment interaction is how one gets cancer. Now, therefore, with that in mind, about 30% of all colon cancers that we see has some degree of familial kind of link. In other words, about 30% of colon cancers that we see in our day-to-day practice has someone in the family who has been afflicted with the same cancer before, indicating that there's some degree of genetic linkage. So one's family history does play a part in one's future risk of acquiring a cancer. And that's what makes the study of genes in cancer so much more interesting. Yeah, I mean, colon cancer is one of those few cancers where we do know a lot more about in terms of the genes that can cause it. So in that 30% of colon cancers where we see some tendency towards inheritance of the risk, we do know a number of genes that we can actually ascertain through a simple blood test and to find out the genetic code that could gauge your risk of acquiring a colon cancer somewhere down the line. But the first, the process starts actually by first having interaction with the patient to find out what kind of family history he or she has, right? Having a comprehensive view of the family history gives us an idea of who in the family has cancer and how many of the family members has cancer and what age they acquire cancer. All this gives us an appreciation of the kind of risk that a person has. Most of the time, if the person has relations that are very close, first-degree relatives we call them, meaning either your own parents or your siblings, where there's very strong direct blood links, has a cancer, especially if they have it fairly young, below the age of 40, especially if they're in their 30s and 40s, then we say that the risk is much, much higher of a gene being at risk in this family. And so we can then begin to figure out in this family, based on the pattern of occurrence, which gene we should be targeting.